But of course, not all who are bitten change. There must be something wild within. An analog of the wolf.
Well, that lets me out. Among my people, I'm known as the guy least likely to have an analog of the wolf.
Your people are wrong, Mr. Randall. Sometimes one doesn't even need to be bitten. Only the passion of the wolf is enough.
Dr. Alezais, what I would like to know, and not that I subscribe to any of this.
Neither do I, really. Only to the possibility.
But out of curiosity, is there supposed to be any way to stop this metamorphosis?
Supposedly there are herbs and rites and amulets. I don't know the rites. I don't have the herbs. But I did find something for you when you called. This is one of the most powerful amulets, which must be worn next to the skin and never taken off. If it works, there is said to be a great pain and weakness while the wolf struggles to emerge, and charm holds him at bay, sometimes drives him out. I have no idea if any of it is true, but it's yours.
Oh, no,
it's a gift. And in return, I would like a favor from you.
It's in my power.
I was recently told that I'm dying. Speaking of mystical and terrifying experiences, I would like you to bite me.
What?
I would like you to bite me. I can't ask you to transform me with your passion, so I ask you to honor me with your bite, and I too will become a demon wolf.
You'd rather be damned than die.
Damnation is not a part of my system of beliefs. The demon wolf is not evil, unless the man he's bitten is evil. And it feels good to be wolf, doesn't it? Power without guilt, love without doubt. If you decide to believe, perhaps you will give me your gift. It has been a privilege. I've never seen one.